I'm Dustin Cormier, and this is the How to Rock Astrology audio series. The information in this recording is copyrighted by Dustin Cormier, 2015, all rights reserved, except where noted in the recording. The following information on ascendant or rising signs comes from Stephen Arroyo's Chart Interpretation Handbook, copyrighted in 1989 by Stephen Arroyo, published by CRCS Publications in Sebastopol, California. I do not own the following content. Guidelines to Interpreting the Ascendant. Although the ascendant is of deep and pervasive importance for each individual, there is no denying that it must be related to the rest of the chart, and especially to the sun sign, in order to understand it thoroughly for a particular person. The sun, after all, is the core identity, the very center of the consciousness, the way we assimilate much of our experience. Whereas the ascendant, although it varies in importance from person to person, is not as central to the person's nature. It shows, among other things, the approach to life, but the sun shows life itself. The ascendant must serve the purposes, values, and creative goals of the sun for the individual to function happily and fully. A useful tool for understanding how a person's ascendant and sun sign interact is to compare the elements of the two factors. For example, a Cancer sun sign person with a fire sign rising is usually far more extroverted, forcefully expressive, and confident than a Cancer sun individual with, say, a more conservative, self-protective earth sign rising. For another example, an air sign sun person with a water sign rising may appear much more emotional than he or she really is, whereas a water sign sun person with an air sign rising may appear far more detached and less emotional than he or she really is. It should be pointed out that people are often relatively unaware of their ascendant nature as compared to their sun sign. In that sense, the ascendant is a factor that can be consciously developed further over time and consciously utilized to aid one's self-expression. I've known people who are relieved to find what their rising signs were, since it finally gave them a way of identifying a very deep but only semi-conscious tendency in themselves. In some cases, the qualities and abilities symbolized by the ascendant were just beginning to emerge, and learning the astrological keys to this factor helped personal development greatly. I should emphasize here that perhaps more than with most other factors in the chart, the early environment can encourage or suppress the expression of the ascendant's energies, since it is a primary channel with which one interacts with the outer world. The reader should view the following comparative evaluations as guidelines and as questions to explore, rather than as rigid statements of absolute truth. Leo modality, or quadruplicity. The Leo modality is fixed, the determined energy mode. There are exactly four of these willful, determined signs in the zodiac belonging to the fixed modality. These include Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius, and Taurus, and they all share similar characteristics. These four signs are better able to focus and concentrate than the other eight signs. They share a deliberateness and a powerful ability to focus and endure, but they also share the challenge of avoiding stubbornness and close-minded rigidity. The element of the ascendant. The element of the ascendant reveals the quality of energy flow directly vitalizing the physical body and the overall approach to life. Fire or air signs rising tend to conduct energy, encouraging active self-expression and dynamic expenditure of energy. Earth or water rising signs tend to conserve and resist the flow of vital energies, and hence indicate self-containment, sometimes self-repression, and the tendency of living within oneself. Fire signs rising, Aries, Leo, and Sagittarius. Great vitality, physically energetic, beams energy outward into the world. Marked by a positive, optimistic outlook on life and a confident, bluntly honest demeanor. Active, wants to make a mark on life and see the results of one's efforts manifested in the world. Action orientation can lead to wasteful excesses and less awareness of the subtler needs of self and others. Leo ascendant. A Leo ascendant often seems to motivate a person to try hard to express one's best self. That is not to say that the pride and even arrogance of the sign Leo is completely absent from those with Leo rising, It does appear that they have less need to lord it over other people than those with the Leo Sun do. The Leo Ascendant seems to encourage an especially authentic expression of the person's Sun energy, whereas the Leo Sun person often displays a more self-conscious dramatization of his or her deeper feelings. Big-heartedness, often said to be a trait of Leo, seems to be more a reliable quality in those with Leo Ascendant than with Leo Sun, which is so often insensitively manipulating for others for personal gain. Leo Ascendant can, however, demonstrate an extremely aloof bearing and, because of their inordinate need for respect and a show of dignity, often seems to lack the spontaneous humor and playfulness of Leo Sun. The following information comes from Isabel Hickey's classic text, Astrology, A Cosmic Science, copyrighted in 1992 by Isabel M. Hickey Trust, published by CRCS Publications in Sebastopol, California.
I do not own the following content.
Leo on the Ascendant. Self-confident, romantic and sentimental, emotional and extroverted. Courageous, but sometimes foolhardy. Loves to take risks, a zest for life. Impulsive, but faithful to those they love. Can be stubborn in a sunny sort of way. Likes sports and activity out of doors. Strong vitality, but need to keep spine supple by exercise. Large shoulders, small hips like the lion. Can be quick-tempered, but can't stay angry. Like the lion, they roar and lash their tail about a bit, then the storm dies down. Don't walk on their dignity or hurt their pride. They forgive, but don't forget. Their need for love is very great. If frustrated, they have no desire to live. Psychological heart trouble leads to trouble with the physical heart. The following information comes from The Secrets of Your Rising Sign by William Lamb with Webb Harris, Jr., copyrighted by William Lamb in 2004, first published in the USA by Fairwinds Press in Gloucester, Massachusetts. I do not own the following content. Lordly Leo exhibits a generous and sunny disposition. People with Leo rising are bold and assertive, and possibly unruly as children. They resent being told what to do, but their willful independence breeds confidence and competence in adulthood, creating consummate showmen, effective attention-getters, and masters of the big impression. Leos have lion-hearted fearlessness and a good dose of romantic appeal. These people stand out from the crowd. They believe in doing it right the first time. Stand aside, I'll generously show you how to do this, and you can do it the next time. They're often fond of jewelry and might come off as a bit too full of themselves. Physical type. Healthy robustness, able to get by with relatively little sleep, noticeable crown to the head. Favored colors, gold, orange, forest green. The following information comes from Isabel Hickey's Astrology, A Cosmic Science, copyrighted in 1992 by Isabel M. Hickey Trust, published by CRCS Publications in Sebastopol, California. The significance of the Sun and the Sun Sign in Astrology. The symbol of the Sun in astrology is a circle with a dot in the middle. This is a very deep occult spiritual symbolism. The circle represents the eternal self that did not start here and does not finish here on Earth. The dot in the middle represents the divine spark at the center of every living cell, the light which lighteth every man with which cometh into the world. It is the point of light at the center of every living cell. In the blueprint, the sun represents the main expression of the individual, the heart and core of beingness. The sun has a different effect on individuals born at different times of the year. According to the sign and house in which the sun is placed, we are able to judge the general vitality and physique, the qualities of leadership, and the individual's ability to succeed in life. In a personal chart, the sun represents the basic drive for significance, the will, male relationships and female charts, especially with the father, vital energy coming from the etheric levels and prana, fuel on which the total personality operates, urge for power, constitutional strength, and finally, a powerful sun means very great power to do and to be. Keywords of the sun: will, individuality, spirit. The sun is the significator of the spirit in man. the beingness or isness of life. It rules the basic drive for significance, the will to be. Physically, the sun is the sustainer of life, giver of light, heat, and energy. More than anything else in the chart, it shows the will, man's highest expression. Its aspects show deep character traits, the chief ambitions. It needs aspects to the planets for strength of expression in the horoscope. As the sun moves through the signs, its return to the sign of its exaltation, Aries, the eastern horizon, marks the beginning of the astrological year. Springtime brings the release of a new cycle of life. As the sun moves through the houses, its return to the eastern horizon is the beginning of the astrological day, sunrise. The sun sign in its element. The following information comes from Stephen Arroyo's Chart Interpretation Handbook, copyrighted in 1989 by Stephen Arroyo, published by CRCS Publications in Sebastopol, California. I do not own the following content. The sun sign's element is usually dominant in considering the overall psychology of a person. This is so because the sun sign's element reveals the attunement of one's basic vitality, identity, and power of self-projection, as well as the fundamental quality of his or her consciousness. The element of one's sun sign reveals the basic inner force motivating everything we do. The element of the sun sign also gives insight into how any individual sees life itself and what expectations they have of the life experience. Aries Sun. Aries is a fire sign. These are the common characteristics of people born with the sun in fire signs. Basically motivated by inspirations and aspirations. Recharges energy through vigorous, physically demanding activity and by pursuing new visions for the future. Interpretive guidelines for the sun in Aries. Radiates forceful, confident vitality. Tries to fill need for recognition with self-assertion and direct, competitive actions. Forceful assertion of individuality is necessary for full self-expression. Identifies self as explorer, pioneer, the first to begin an adventure. Quickly grasps essentials. May antagonize others with too forceful expression of individuality. This final article comes from The Secrets of Your Rising Sign, by William Lamb with Webb Harris, Jr., copyrighted by William Lamb in 2004, first published in the USA by Fairwinds Press in Gloucester, Massachusetts. I do not own the following content. Aries born early afternoon. Aries with Leo rising. Nobody else in the zodiac makes a bigger, early bird catches the worm splash than Aries, and here it's wrapped up in a warm, sunny, robust, big impression, lordly Leo personality. Upbeat, springtime Aries' positive, honest, and expedient character sets the stage beautifully for Leo's stand aside, I'll show you how to do this kind of attitude. These Arians leave a striking impression. They're good at inspiring others and taking the lead on things. However, they're not the best followers. They don't like being told what to do. They're naturally independent, and when it's necessary to spend time in the underling's chair, they'd better have a very long leash to satiate their restlessness. Arians with Leo rising are great promoters and fabulous entertainers. In fact, they're usually entertaining, no matter what their particular career. But their life's work might lead them to promotional positions. They're usually good salespeople, as long as they're left alone to do things their own way. Working out of town or on the road might well be their cup of tea. That is, if they can pull themselves away from their adoring family. Leo rising usually makes for an invested parent. They're ideally equipped for starting a small business, although their Aries impatience might require them to hire someone else to do routine and tedious managerial tasks or lengthy inventories. Leo's magnanimous generosity is one of these people's more endearing traits. They give freely of their time, consideration, and means. Leo's fondness for children, coupled with Aries' competitiveness, might lead them into coaching youth sports, although ultimately they're a bit hard-driving and not so long-suffering, given their do-it-right-the-first-time attitude. Leo is, above all, the consummate showman, So when Leo rises, the impression left with people is paramount. Because Arians are already given to a healthy opinion of themselves, Arians born early afternoon need to steer clear of coming off as self-absorbed and self-serving, so as not to compromise their Aries childlike honesty and charm. They need to be aware of how they're being received and adjust their reactions accordingly. The best showmen are always aware of how their audience is receiving them. These Arians can expect screaming success if they remember to always manifest a clear and genuine interest in the people around them.